Well, signs of the storm can still be seen throughout town today. Some residents tell me although the brunt of the storm only lasted about 20 minutes, the wind alone was enough to send some to their basements. The landfill won't reach capacity for about another 25 years, but that's still a concern. That's because on average, the landfill gets about 600 tons of trash a day. Now the agency is exploring their options as it's filling up.
It's a very active scene right now. Behind me, you could probably see there are some cars still completely off the tracks on their sides. And then further down this way, we'll give you a look. There are cars completely crunched together. But luckily, there were no reported injuries.
Now, if you've ever been concerned about a friend, neighbor, or coworker's mental health, but you didn't know how to help, this class is for you. It focuses on helping regular community members identify somebody who's in a crisis or who's suffering and getting them help.
Even if you don't know how to ski or snowboard, they have classes here to help you get down the slopes. And rentals for those without gear overall.
Well, Ron, it is amazing that that person walked away from the accident with no injuries. 24-year-old Richard Hooray was traveling westbound on 8th Avenue towards me when his driver's side of his car was struck.
A sea of climate activists of all ages holding signs took over downtown Iowa City to hear from Greta Thunberg.
We must always carry on, and we must never allow ourselves to give up.
Those in the crowd agreeing about the urgency.
It's try or die trying. I mean, if this doesn't make a difference, we have to say at least we fought for it.
Several Iowa City City High School students spoke urging the University of Iowa to shut down their coal-fired plant and commit to 100% renewable energy by 2030.
President Harrell.
A UI grad student agreed.
We all have a duty to try to convert to renewable energy, and, you know, as a University of Iowa student, I would, you know, really advocate that, you know, University of Iowa can, you know, do its part.
Greta also spoke of the UN Climate Summit, calling it a disappointment.
To stand behind and speak the science is still too uncomfortable for them, and that needs to change.
Saying children shouldn't have to take it on their shoulders, but would if the adults failed. That struck a chord.
Definitely well spoken, and she hit all the high points. We need to be the adults in the room.
Greta and other young speakers inspired many young ones in the crowd.
It's cool because I'm almost as old as her.
To not use plastic anymore except for when you need it.
Every single thing in the world that's big right now, every big thing starts small and it grows. So.
The day started off with the basics.
Need to, you can choke up.
Okay.
There you go. That's a lot easier.
Crawdaddy owner Darren Sifkin says proper gear and boat control are important before getting on moving water.
Familiar with a stretch of river and what are the potential hazards out there? Are there dams? Are there trees down?
During the skills portion, I jumped in a kayak myself.
They say practicing your balance is one of the most important things before going down the course.
It takes a little bit of skill to do some of the whitewater course. Not a tremendous amount here at Manchester.
If you were on Highway 218 or Interstate 80 this morning, you probably noticed a very heavy police presence. It was part of a campaign to remind drivers what to do when they see any cars on the shoulders with flashing lights.
Now that's what you should be doing right there. Get on the brakes, slowing down a little bit. That blue truck did exactly what we want him to do.
Today's scenario is a tow truck along the shoulder. According to the law, everyone should be slowing down and getting over. For the most part, people got the idea.
We're not issuing a bunch of tickets. Most of the people are getting over pretty well. I like seeing that. Unfortunately, I would say it's not real representative of how it happens to us every day.
However, some failed to either slow down or move over. This car did neither.
Slow down means below the speed limit, and you were at 74, so you're actually four over, and you had time to move over. So that's why I'm stopping today, okay?
Whether it's pulling someone over or assisting a stranded motorist, it's a dangerous job. In 2019, 28 tow or maintenance vehicles had already been hit, according to HDR, who works with the Iowa DOT.
This is probably the number one thing I worry about dying from, is getting hit on the side of the road doing my job. I try and impart that wisdom into everybody I deal with on the side of the road and say, listen, this is the most dangerous place you are.
In January, a semi-truck hit a patrol car, nearly striking a state trooper. Now, that car that was pulled over said that they didn't see us along the road or the car with hazards behind us. Trooper Conrad says that can happen when people aren't paying attention. They hope the $195 ticket encourages them to do so. Reporting in Johnson County. This is the first year that they're doing it, so the idea is every Friday the students trade in their cell phones for a conversation starter and get randomly assigned to sit with a group that they may not know so well.
Somebody take charge and write that stuff down.
Principal Janet Behrens is asking for student feedback, but what she wants even more is for students to strike up a conversation.
But she sits with her grade. Sit by you if you would sit by me at lunch.
It's kind of a lost art at this point. You know, we do everything so much based on technology that sometimes we struggle to just sit and have a conversation.
She says at first, students were a bit apprehensive.
There was a little bit of, oh, this is going to be terrible. We don't want to do this.
But a couple weeks in now, and students are realizing it's not so bad.
It's been interesting. I mean, I like the idea. I mean, it's a good idea because we are usually very attached to our phones.
It's fun, you know, meeting new people and, like, learning about them.
Each week, different conversation starters help break the ice.
We always go off from them, but they definitely start to help with, like, to bring a conversation in.
So, like, by the time we get to the end of the school year, we'll be used to it, and it'll be pretty easy, I feel like.
Now, Friday lunches include a serving of good conversation.
I just feel like I know more people in the school, and, like, I have more friends that way, you know?
Well, I'm out here on Miller Avenue in the southwest side of Cedar Rapids. This stretch of road behind me is the exact spot that Rhonda and Casey Ringer's daughter, Sharina, was killed when a truck turned left in front of her motorcycle. Now they have a message for drivers.
Look twice for motorcycles. Someone's whole world is on that bike.
Look twice, a message the Ringer family has been spreading ever since their daughter's 26-year-old Sharina was killed in a motorcycle accident due to a lethal left-hand turn.
So her motorcycle struck the front of his SUV, and so she landed actually right here in front of us.
At the time of the accident, all four wheels of his vehicle were in her lane, in the eastbound lane, and she hit head on. And his words were, I thought I had more time.
There's a reason why there aren't any scratch bakeries out there. There's just no money in it.
Owner John Richark will be the first to tell you he didn't dream of opening a bakery.
Still doesn't really want to own a bakery.
But it's the history that drew him in.
Just check. Yeah. Seriously.
Recipes and equipment that have survived the decades are keeping the traditions alive.
We're making the hoska here now. We make rohlik and babovka and a lot of Czech items.
Traditions now being passed to the next generation.
When I bite into them, I can kind of see the juice stuff, and I know the bread's baked.
The sweet smell of kolaches draws a crowd, even from out of state.
My rule when I'm traveling is to never go anywhere that I could go at home. So I'm always drawn to the local coffee shop.
Now, that's all being threatened.
I got a letter 4 months ago that said every year for the next 4 years, it's going to go up 25%. The premium is going to go up 25%.
While the items are worth savoring, $2 kolaches don't bring in the big bucks. So they're looking at other options.
If I had some revenue from the upstairs, we'll be able to make that manage with the exorbitant flood insurance. I can't make it go away, but at least I can find the funds to pay for it.
Darren Bogner is coming up on 25 years delivering for USPS. Through sunshine and snowstorms, he's seen it all. Unfortunately, some of it keeps him up at night.
It stays with you for the rest of your career.
It's the unpleasant surprise of a dog attack.
People think that their dog won't bite, but I know from experience that any dog can bite.
Over the years, he's been bitten 3 times, once requiring stitches.
This is actually the place where one of my dog bites happened.
He's always cautious of closed gates and what could be waiting behind them. He's not the only one. Earlier in the morning, carriers gathered.
We want our dog bite to be the last dog bite.
To share their own scares, hoping people put their pups inside during delivery hours.
Of 80,000 deliveries that we do on a regular basis, we're not really sure where the danger is going to be. It's going to be at any house that has a dog or any dog that is running loose.
Dogs have jumped fences to take a bite.
It cleared that fence like it wasn't even there.
Bogner hopes if there's an encounter, they're on a leash with the owner in control.
Your dog may be the nicest dog in the world, but it doesn't know me. and it doesn't know my substitute.
They're asking customers to check the block before letting their dogs out of the house.